Also known as TRNR, is also known as father of Indian nuclear program. APJ Abdul Kalam, Awal Pakir Jainul Abdeen Abdul Kalam, was an Indian aerospace scientist and widely referred to as People's President. He came to be known as Missile Man of India due to his contributions in development of ballistic missile and launch vehicle technology. He received many awards. Srinivasa Ramanujan. Srinivasa Ramanujan Iyengar was an Indian mathematician during British rule in India. Though he had no formal training in pure mathematics, he developed his own mathematical research. He made contributions to mathematical analysis, number theory, infinite series, and continued fractions, including the problems that are considered unsolvable. Satyendranath Bose was an Indian mathematician and physicist, patients on quantum machines, and developed Bose-Einstein statistics and the theory of Bose. Was an Indian physicist and astronomer who initiated space research and helped develop nuclear power in India. He is regarded as the father of Indian Subramanyam Chandrasekhar. Subramanyam Chandrasekhar was an Indian-American astrophysicist who spent his professional life in the United States. He contributed greatly on the theoretical studies of the physical processes of the importance to the structure and evolution of stars. Meghnad Saha. Meghnad Saha was an Indian astrophysicist who developed the Saha ionization equation used to describe chemical and physical conditions in stars. His works allowed astronomers to accurately relate the spectral classes of stars to their actual temperatures. Har Gobind Khurana was an Indian-American biochemist. He contributed greatly in the order of nucleotides and nucleic acids, which carry the genetic mode of the cell and control the cell synthesis of proteins. He received many awards due to his contributions.
Very good.
My second homework was find out which Indian states the tropic of cancer passes. So the tropic of cancer passes through 8 states in India: Jastan in Gujarat, Kalinjar in Rajasthan, Chajapur in Madhya Pradesh, Sonhat in Chhattisgarh, Lohardaga in Jharkhand, Krishnanagar in West Bengal, Udaipur in Tripura, and Champa in Mizoram. So our third homework was 5 to 10 examples of animals that live in polar region. So they are polar bear, Arctic fox, Arctic hare, snowy owl, seal, Arctic wolf, penguin, narwhal, Arctic tern, and moose.
Very good. Next. Very good, Satvika. Next, you can voluntarily, you can come up and you can say the homework. Fast. Ahana Singh, Nikhil, Jait, Reddy Ashwini, Ritvik, Shiva Pranam, and Swasti. Unmute yourself and you can speak. If you've done the homework, you just tell the homework. If you didn't do the homework, tell the reason, what is the main reason behind that. But don't be silent so that we'll continue the class further. I hope there is no issue from my side about the voice and all. You can
sir,
hear
your
me?
Voice is low, sir.
No, sir, it's clear for me.
Okay, what about the remaining?
Sir, your voice is a little bit low, sir.
But it is very clear only from my side. There is no issue at all. What about the remaining people?
Sir, it's
clear. You are facing any issues today?
Yes, I'm facing some issues.
Yeah, so stay, please rejoin once again. Or try to increase your mobile or the laptop volume. Okay. So about the homework, remaining people. Did you finish it or not? Or raise your hands who didn't complete the homework. You can raise your hands frankly. I'll not say anything.
Sir, yesterday you told that I will not accept that top 16, but I found that only, sorry, more I did not found.
Sorry, Ritchie, can you repeat again?
Sir, actually, yesterday when I'm telling in the ask, you told that no need, tomorrow you find more scientists and tell me. So yeah. I found only 16, so.
Okay, no problem.
Sir, I told you already, so.
Okay, good. So those who didn't do the homework, raise your hands. The remaining all did the homework. Okay. So do one thing. Whatever the four questions I have given for you, you just write it down in your classwork notes. Okay. Write down classwork notes. I will ask you to show tomorrow itself. Okay. Everyone.
Yeah. Okay. Sir.
First, write it down in the classwork notes. I will tell you how to submit that homework to me afterwards in the group. So we will continue with the topic. Especially we discussed up to the adaptation of animals, in the polar region for the polar bear as well as the penguins. So what are the adaptional behaviors are there total for the polar bear?
Sir.
Yeah. So it has a thick white color fur so that it can camouflage with the surrounding environment. The next one.
Sir, and its ears are small.
It has long and short sharp claws.
And it has a thick layer of fat below its skin called blubber.
Okay, good.
It has sharp and big claws.
It has a sharp and big claws so that it can walk on the ice easily and it can swim easily.
Yeah, next. Sir. And also, it has a fat layer under its skin.
It has also a fat layer under its skin. What is the main
thing? Sir, it has a...
Sir, and it has a strong smelling sense and to catch the predator easily.
Very good. So what is
it? Sir, it can camouflage by its surroundings with its skin color.
Okay. Yes, sir. Right.
Yeah, Nikhil. Right. Nikhil, unmute yourself. Yeah, Nikhil, what is the main purpose of having the thick fat layer under the skin for the polar bear? What is the main uses? Nikhil. Nikhil, unmute yourself.
Sir, can I?
Wait, I will give chance to each and everyone. I'll ask you questions, okay? Don't worry.
Sir, I'm Nikhil, sir.
Yeah, Nikhil.
I'm having network issue.
Okay. So what is the answer, Nikhil?
Sir, can repeat the question once again?
So generally, polar bear will have the thick fat layer under its skin, right?
Yes, sir.
So what is the main purpose and what is the uses of that thick layer?
Sir, polar bear have that thick layer. And
sir, they have to protect from extreme cold weather.
Yeah, please.
And they store fats over there. And when the cold climate and in the cold climates, the fat helps the fat convert into food and it.
The fat, whatever the fat stored, it will convert into the food during the hibernation time. Good. The next one is it spread the polar bear from the cool climate. So it will give you somewhat. It will keep the body warm. Very good. Next one is Ahana Singh.
So once again, can you send this class notes in Google Classroom? I could not find it.
Yeah, sure. I will send it today. Or by tomorrow morning, it will be there in your Google Classroom, all the class recordings and all. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Sure. So next one is So why the polar bear is having small ears, Ahana Singh?
What, sir?
Why the polar bears is having small ears?
So can I say?
Ahana, I'll call you one by one. So each and everyone will get the question, don't worry. Ahana?
Sir, actually she has a low mic problem, so she just posted the chat.
Okay. So next we'll give this chance to Shiva Pranav. Why the polar bear is having small ears? So what is the importance of that? What happened, Shiva is left.
Sir, can I?
Srusti? Srusti?
Yes, sir.
What is the answer for that?
Sir, can you repeat the question again?
Why the polar bear having the small ears? Can you hear me or not?
Sir, we can hear you.
Sure, okay. Mahavir? Mahavir, yes, unmute yourself and you can answer that question.
Yes, sir, I forgot to unmute.
What is the answer?
Sir,
fast. Very good, Ahana. Ritvik, it's not about the fat. Sorry, you send the answer, but it's not about the fat. No, I can't hear you, Mahavir. Generally, polar bear will have the small ears because if they have the small ears, no, they will have the minimum surface area outside.
And, in order to prevent heat loss.
In order to prevent heat loss, it will have the small ears.
It also do not allow fat to come, do not allow fat from the body to produce.
No, ears and fats, there is no link up, right? Okay, just read it again, that point. Ears and fats, there is no link up. Generally, to have the small ears to minimize the surface area of their body. So where the heat loss will happen. If you have the small surface area now, the heat loss will not happen that much from the body. Okay, so next we'll come back to the penguins. Already we discussed in the last class. It will have the same properties except the streamlined body or finger-like whips and web-footed for the penguins. And penguins always move in the group in order to keep
themselves warm. They will huddle together to keep themselves warm.
So next one is the migration. So have you seen the migration anywhere?
Yeah.
Migration of the birds?
Yes, sir. They actually migrate from the polar regions to different places. Like if you come to India and all, in order to adjust, if it is winter there, it will be like summer over here, right? So they'll come over here.
So first important point is what? Migration is the seasonal journey taken by different animals or birds to escape the extreme climatic conditions. And in the search of food. That is the main definition for the migration. It's not the regular journey. It is a seasonal journey taken by the different animals. It may not be only the birds. It can be taken by any other animals also. For what they are taking the journey? To escape from the extreme climatic conditions and the search of the food. Okay, understand this point? If you see this, during the winter season also, so many birds will come from outside our country to the India. And during the summer season, the birds from the India also will lead to some other countries where they will feel comfortable and the cool climates. So if you take the example, Siberian cranes migrate towards warmer region in the case of winter season by traveling several thousands of kilometers. Okay. So that some of the cranes also come to the India in some places. What is the name of the places? It's Bharatpur, Rajasthan, Sultanpur.
Rajasthan and Sultanpur,
Haryana, and sometimes. And sometimes in the wetland of Northeast and other part of India. What is this wetland? Anybody knows what is a wetland in India?
Sir, is it Meghalaya?
Meghalaya or Assam. The northern states will have the continuous rainfall itself, right?
Yeah, sir, it has continuous rainfall and it will be always wet.
Wet only will be there, but that's not exactly the wetland. Have you listened the word Sundarban Delta? The largest delta in the world.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, no?
Yes, sir.
Sundarban Delta is there. So, backside of these deltas, we have the wetlands. Okay, so always there is a brackish water from the sea. There is a wetland will form always. Okay, so wetland means always they will have the different types of organisms will live in that wetland. So again, some migratory birds will feed on the fishes or something else on the aquatic animals in the wetland areas. So only they will travel from thousands of kilometers to escape the winter season in that region. Okay, so only they are coming to the India. So if you take the Rajasthan, completely desert area, it's a warmer only. Sultanpur, Bharatpur, Haryana, all these are the northwestern region rains. Somewhat hotter in the case of summer season. So those birds will come to these areas to escape from the winter season in their areas. But how these birds will travel? What are the conditions which will help these birds to go particular place itself?
Sir, they fly a bit high in the sky, sir.
Okay, that is the next.
They form a V shape, sir. The migration of birds.
Okay, you can see.
In the other side, if they are flying in the other side of birds will be cool. They will just fly their hands.
Very good. Someone has told about the whenever the birds are traveling in the group, they will travel in different structures. The most common one is a V shape.
Yes, sir. V shape.
What is the importance of V-shape?
That means if one side of the birds are flying, the another side of the birds will be cool, sir. Means it will not fly. It will take rest. So if the other side of the birds will fly, then the opposite side will be cool. Means it will go.
They will fly. It will not fly.
Okay, good.
Sir, it will not fly, right? On opposite side.
They will fly,
but whatever the exposure to the air or whatever the heat is there, it will not get that much. Whichever the birds are flying somewhat backer than the front one, they will not experience that much of opposite air wind directions, or you can say the heat, that one. So again, they will change the position continuously from one to other positions and all. Okay, so these birds fly high when the wind flow is helpful and the cold conditions allow them to disperse the heat generated by their flight muscles. Do you understand this point? Generally,
yes, sir, yes.
Whenever the migration birds are there, they will fly at the higher altitudes in the atmosphere. Because as we go to higher altitudes, the temperature is very low. And also wind also will be somewhat low. So wind flow is helpful and the cold conditions allow them to disperse the heat generated by the flight muscles. So whatever the heat is produced by the body of the birds, it will be dispersed easily in the case of higher altitudes. These birds have their built-in sense of direction and know in which direction they have to travel. What is the main point of this? Whatever the migratory birds are there, they know they have the built-in sense of direction. Means they will, if you want to travel from one place to other place in a particular seasons, they will travel.
Yeah, exactly. They like this to remember the route, sir. Even dogs, whenever they get separated by their master, they'll automatically return to the house, sir, because once they travel through that route, they'll memorize it.
They'll remember the routes with the help of the senses, whether it can be sense, a smell, or the look, or any other things, or by remembering some hills, or the climatic conditions, or according to the stars and all. Okay? That is the first thing. Or some birds use the landmark to guide them. Just now we discussed, right, about the landmarks, about the mountains or about the hills areas.
Yes, sir.
About the forest and all. They'll use some landmarks to guide them. Some birds are guided by the sun during the daytime and by the stars during the nighttime. Okay. So birds also have too much of knowledge, right? So only they are using the different techniques to travel from one place to other place.
Yeah.
What about the bats? They will produce the ultrasonic sounds. So with the help of that, they will travel from one place to other place during the night time. So some birds use the magnetic field of the earth to find the directions. Beside birds, some fishes, insects, and mammals also migrate seasonally in search of more hospitable climates. Any doubts in this paragraph?
No, sir.
Srishti, you raised your hand. Any doubts? So what are the different techniques birds are using to migrate from one place to other place?
Sir, it has a built sense of direction.
They are traveling at the higher altitudes.
Yes, sir. And they use landmarks to remember the places.
Okay, good. Using the landmarks to remember the places. Yeah, some are guided by the sun during the daytime, and some are.
And some during the night time.
Or some will use the magnetic field of the earth to go in a particular direction. And if you take the bats, they will use the ultrasonic sounds. They will produce ultrasonic sounds. So they will travel in the different directions. Any doubts in the migration now?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
Yes or no, Ritik?
No, sir. No.
Okay, just do one activity work. Find out the migratory birds that are coming to the India during any season, okay? So in which season some migratory birds will come to the India? Like activity work, okay?
Sir, which season?
No, I'm asking you. Some migratory birds will come to India, right, from other countries. You can find out in which
Siberian crane. Sir, one of it is Siberian crane.
Yeah, that I already given in the notepad itself the example. You can find out for other birds.
Okay, sir.
Okay. The next one is the tropical rainforest. So, what is a tropical rainforest? What is a tropical region first?
Sir, it's like a wet region. It's a thick area of forest, sir, and it lies near the equator, sir. Both sides.
Okay. What is a tropical region first?
They have plenty of
rain. The time the rain will come.
Tropical region is nothing but the region between the equator and the Tropic of Cancer or the Tropic of Capricorn, right?
Yes, sir.
Whatever the region lies between the Tropic of Cancer to the Tropic of Capricorn along with the equator is called as a tropical region. Generally, this region is very hot.
Yes, sir. And it receives a lot of rainfall, sir. So, it's really humid.
So, we cannot say the region is completely hot itself because in this region only you can experience the different types of seasons. First thing, we'll have the winter season, we have the summer season, we have the rainy season. All the different seasons will come. Unlike polar region. Polar region is what? Only completely snow will be there. But it's not like that here, right?
Yes,
we'll experience the different climatic conditions throughout the year. So only we have the different seasons.
Sir, some season. Some months it will be like 2-3 months it will be winter. Some 2-3 months it will be rainy and 2-3 months it will be sunny.
Yeah. These seasons are hot, but also get the plenty of rainfall. Therefore, the region is called as humid. Humid is nothing but the amount of water vapor in it.
Sir, the amount of water present in the
atmosphere
is humid.
Okay, good. So, the temperature is generally, in the case of winters, the temperature is around average of 15 to 20 degrees Celsius. But in the case of summers, it will cross up to 40 degrees. But if you take the temperature in the case of polar region, it will always minus 20 to minus 30 degrees only, right?
Yeah, yes, sir. Because it's really very cool, extreme cool.
But here, even though in the winter season also, this temperature is around average of 15 degrees Celsius.
Yes, sir.
So,
and one more important point is, the day and night are almost equal in length throughout the year. So whatever the tropical region is there, the day and night will be almost equal throughout the year. So tropical rainforest is the important. Yeah.
So in winter, they'll say that the nights will be more and the days will be short. And in the summer, they'll say that days are long and nights are shorter.
But in this region, they're almost equal.
Okay. See, we can say the difference only in the terms of minutes or the hours. If you take the winter season now, mostly, can you hear me? Hello? Hello. Guys, can you hear me or not? Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, yes, sir. Now we can hear you.
1 minute, please.
Not hearing.
Now.
Voice is breaking.
Now?
Yeah, for now.
Okay, sorry. So if you take the tropical region, almost the length of the day and nights are equal only. But here, when you say in the tropical regions also, yeah, obviously summer will have the more time, you can say more length, or night will be have the shorter length. But that is not that much of difference like in the polar regions. In the case of polar regions, it will be completely day only. There is no night at all for 6 months. And completely next 6 months are completely night. There is no day at all. But here almost it is equal, right? That's what it said, almost equal. It's not exactly equal. Take the average, no, it's almost equal. Only little minutes different will be there. That's all. Okay, Jait?
Okay, sir.
The next, tropical rainforest is an important feature of tropical region. These regions are rich in vegetation and the large diversity in animals also seen in this region. What is the meaning of diversity? What is the meaning of diversity?
Sir, like being different.
Diversity means what?
Sir, becoming different.
Not becoming different. Raghav?
Sir?
Sir, different forest.
What is the meaning of diversity?
Sir, means a large group of birds disperse.
Sir, are there?
Yeah, I was there, but what is the meaning of diversity?
Sir, it means like variety, sir.
Very good. Diversity, sir, we can tell variety of the things will be together. If you take forest, there are various type of animals and plants will live together, right?
Yeah, sir. Sir, also in tropical rainforest, very rare animals will be there.
You can say India is a diversity country. That means different religions, people, different
cultures, animals and different birds.
Different, yes. Different cultures, different languages, different religions, all will be together itself in the
different.
India. Yes or no?
Yeah, sir.
That's a diversified country, we can say India. Like diversity means variety of the things which are staying together. So yes, if you see the rainforest. Yeah.
So some of the rare animals also live in tropical rainforest, right?
Yeah. So tropical rainforest is an important feature for tropical region because it has a rich in vegetation and the large diversity in the animals. We cannot
see. Sir, and the birds over there, they live in the like upper canopy of tall trees, sir. And mostly animals living on trees are arboreals and they are adapted to live on the trees only, sir.
Okay, we'll discuss one by one in the point by point. So in the India, tropical rainforests are generally found in the Western Ghats and Assam. And if you compare with other countries, it will generally in the Southeast Asia, Central America, Malaysia, Indonesia, Brazil, Republic of Congo, Kenya, Uganda, Nigeria, and Central Africa. These are the countries where the tropical rainforest is present.
Sir, where is Western Ghats?
Yeah, Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats are there, right?
Yeah, I see.
Yes, sir. I'm saying that where are they located?
So, Western Ghats, if you take west side, like Arabian Sea is there, right?
Yes, sir.
Arabian Sea, what are the states are there?
Western Ghats, there is Bay of Bengal.
Bay of Bengal.
Okay, sir.
So, 1 minute, I'll show you the map also. That's better. Can you see?
Yes, sir.
It's not a completely India map. Just you have taken the South India map, okay? Can you see here the left side green color part is completely?
Yes, sir. Western Ghats.
That is a completely Western Ghats. Western Ghats are continuous in nature.
That means, three states will touch the Western Ghats.
Yeah, Maharashtra is there, Karnataka is there.
Karnataka and Kerala.
Okay, and Tamil Nadu also will come, Western Ghats. Tamil Nadu in one place, both the Ghats will match.
Okay, sir.
So Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats.
And Eastern Ghats is Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana.
Telangana will not come for the Eastern Ghat area, right? Ghat area is the one which will separate from the coastal area and the plain areas. So if it's the Eastern Ghats, no, Tamil Nadu will be there. Next Andhra Pradesh will come. Next Odisha will come. It will go in this way. Telangana will be here.
Yes, sir.
So Eastern Ghats will not be there in Telangana at all.
Okay, sir.
So if you know Andhra Pradesh, now you can go. Araku, you know, right? Araku, Vishakhapatnam.
Yes, sir.
suppose all these areas are in the eastern Ghat areas, hilly areas will be there, right? Suppose if you take Kodaikanal, Ooty and all yes, these are present on the eastern Ghats only. Now clear, what is the east, western Ghats and eastern Ghats?
Yes sir.
Simple thing is, whatever the Ghat area is there to the west of the India, that's the western Ghat. To the east of the India, that is the eastern Ghats.
Yes sir.
So where you will find the tropical rainforest? Either eastern Ghat or western Ghat?
Sir, in the western Ghat.
In the western Ghat areas, we'll find the tropical rainforest areas. So in India, tropical rainforest are found in the western Ghats and Assam. Okay. And they have given some other examples like other countries also they have given. So what is the main type of animals are present in this type of forest? What are the major animals?
Mostly like monkeys and all, snakes, elephants.
Elephants, leopards, lizards, snakes, birds, and insects. Sir, can I read?
No, not completely. So different types of, are the major type of animals which are present in the rainforest, tropical rainforest are the monkeys, apes, gorillas, tiger, elephant, leopards, lizard, snakes, birds, and the insects. Okay, so these are the most common animals you can see in the tropical rainforest areas. Since there are large number of animals are found in this region, there is an intense competition for food and shelter among the animals. Yes or no? Diverse variety of the animals are there in this region, so there is
yes,
always
sir. So always for even red-eyed frog also lives there.
Yeah. So always there is a huge competition for the food among the animals itself. So the animals are adapted in such a way that they eat different kinds of food and they live in different kind of places to overcome the competition for the food and shelter. You understand this point?
Yes, sir.
So here also animals have to adapt first, right? Without adaption, they cannot live in that environment at all.
Yes, sir, they cannot.
So animals have to adapt first to the different conditions, to the hotness and to the coldness, for the different seasons, and whatever the food available in the different seasons has to eat. So they have to adapt themselves to the different climatic conditions and the food availability.
Yes, sir.
So this is all about the tropical rainforest. Any doubts in this?
No, sir.
What about the remaining people?
No doubts, sir.
No. So, adaption in the red-eyed frog.
Sir, can I read?
Yeah, first wait. We'll give chance to others. Harini, unmute yourself. First of all, turn on your cam, everyone.
Sir, mine is on.
Yeah, Jait. Only Jait has turned on the cam. Remaining people also turn on your cams.
Harini is typing in the chat box.
Yeah. Harini, unmute yourself. What about Ishan? Nikhil? Yeah, Nikhil?
So can you repeat the question? Because I have a small internet issue, I didn't join.
No, we didn't. I didn't ask any question. Just I asked someone to read this paragraph. I called Nikhil.
Yes, sir. I'm Nikhil, sir.
Yeah, Nikhil, read the paragraph. Adaption.
Adaptations in red-eyed frog. The red-eyed frog lives on trees in tropical rainforest. They have sticky pads on their feet that help them to climb trees. It does not live in water and have green back and a creamy underside. It has a big and bulging bright red eyes and it is a nocturnal. It sleeps during the day and becomes active during the night and feeds on insects present on the tree. The bulging eye of the frog protects it from its predators. The sudden opening of big and bright red eyes frightens the predator for a while and in the meantime the frog gets time to jump to a safe place. The green color of the frog helps it to hide within the green leaves of the tree and helps it to protect from predators.
Okay, good. So the red-eyed frog lives on the trees in tropical rainforest. They have the sticky pads on their feet that help them to climb the trees. Right? Does not live in the water. Generally, normal frogs are the amphibians, right? What's the meaning of amphibians?
Sir, amphibians. Examples of frogs and toads, sir. They live in water, sir. And they breathe through lungs when on land and breathe through skin when in water. And the females lay really harsh legs, sir.
Some amphibians also breathe through lungs. Sorry, gills.
Okay, very good. But simple definition for the amphibians is it can live both on the land as well as on the water.
And water.
Water,
sir. Sir, like hippopotamus.
Yeah, okay.
Sir,
but red frog is an amphibian or not?
Sir, actually, frog or toad, they are main examples of amphibians.
But red-eyed frog is not the amphibian. It does not live in the water.
Yes, sir.
No, but frog is also an amphibian.
Sorry?
Yeah, but this red-eyed frog is not an amphibian.
Yeah, red-eyed frog is not an amphibian.
Yeah, this is only about the red-eyed frog.
Yes.
Okay. So generally it lives on the trees. It does not live in the water and have a green back and a creamy underside. So camouflage with the outside color of the plants or environment. So it is a big and bulged bright red eyes. So whenever the predator is coming, it will open the eyes so that the predator will have some fear. In that meantime, it will escape from the predators. Okay, the green color of the frog helps to hide within the green leaves of the tree and helps it to protect from the predators. So it is one of the most common frog we can see in the tropical rainforest. Next, adaptation in monkeys.
Red frog. Sir, can I read, sir?
Sir, Raghav, can I?
Sir, Ritvik, can I?
Yeah, Raghav.
Sir, I asked last time. Sir.
Okay, next one is for you.
Okay, sir.
Adaptations in monkey. The monkeys living in tropical rainforests have long tails for grasping branches. Their hands and feet are adapted in such a way that they can easily hold the branches of trees. The eyesight of monkeys is very good, which helps them in leaping between the branches to escape from their predators. Monkeys eat fruits, seeds, leaves, root and insects as their food, which is present in abundance in tropical rainforests. Sir, I finished.
Good. So I hope everyone knows how the monkeys are adapted in these climatic conditions. And we are seeing a lot of monkeys in the cities also in the villages. You want to discuss further more on the monkeys?
No, sir.
Yes or no?
No, sir.
We already know it, sir.
I mean, already everyone knows about the monkeys, right? How they
Yes, sir.
Answer, it has long tail and long.
Yeah.
Sir, like,
Yeah. Tell.
Can I retweet now?
Sorry. Can I repeat again? Okay, the next one is adaptation in lion. Tell the
macro. Sir, can I read?
Yeah, Jait.
Adaptations in lion-tailed macaque. It is also called as the beard ape and lives in the rainforest of the western. Sir, is it guards?
That is a guards. Guards, sorry.
Birds in India, it has silver white mane which surrounds the head from the cheeks down to its chin, which is specific characteristic of this animal. It is called as the lion tailed because it is like that. The lion have branch or toothed hair and at the end. They spend most of the time feeding it upper Kanpuri trees.
What is that? Pani puri. So,
not pani puri, sir. Canopy.
Okay.
Example, arboreal animal. It mainly feeds on fruits, seeds, young leaves, stems, flowers, and buds. They also can eat insects present under the bark of the tree. Since it is able to get sufficient food on trees, it rarely comes down on the ground and spends a major part of its life on the trees. It is a good climber with its hands and feet adapted to hold the branches of trees firmly.
Okay. So any doubts in this paragraph?
Yep. So like bird, bear, like
what is the main difference between the monkey and the lion tail macaque?
Sir, actually, lion tail
macaque. Sir, like the monkey won't have the hair in the front of his head, but the beard ape will have the hair in front of the head. That's why it will look like a lion tail macaque.
Sir, and the lion tail macaw, actually, the tail is like a lion, so it's called the lion tail macaw, and it is present in like the western Ghats of India, and it has specific characteristics, sir, and it is mostly white in color, and they live like just on the upper canopy of leaves, sir. I mean, of
the canopy. What is the meaning of canopy? What is the meaning of canopy? Anyone? What is the meaning of canopy? It is called as a lion tailed because it has a tail like a light that of lion. What is the meaning of canopy? Canopy means the upper part of the tree, right? Where the branches and the leaves are there.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, sir.
Now I can hear you, but before not.
Oh, okay, sir.
Okay. So canopy means what? The upper portion of the tree is called as a canopy. Generally, lion tail macaque leaves on the upper part of the tree only. So most of the life it will spend upon that itself. Okay, next one is the adaptation of lions and tigers.
So can you move up some?
So what is your homework today?
Sir, we should find birds which
migratory bird coming to India.
Okay. Write the short note on tropical rainforest in India. Second homework.
Okay, sir.
Write a short note on the tropical rainforest in India.
Okay.
Sir, already we are writing in short only, no, sir.
Sorry?
Sir, already we are writing in a short form only, right?
Okay, short write the same, no problem. So whatever they have given here is a notes only is there. But you also research something about the tropical rainforest climatic conditions in India and you can make it notes.
So could you repeat the homework again?
Yes. Sir, right. Not this.
Write a note or write an essay on the tropical rainforest in India. That's better.
Sir, an essay.
Essay means it's maximum 200 or 300 words is enough. It's better.
Yeah,
right?
For 200 and 300.
300 words on tropical rainforest.
Yeah.
Well, easily it can come
through. So almost if you take the A4 sheets now, at least you will take two papers. Sorry. Okay. So next one is
Can you show the last bit? Yeah.
So last name Lion and Tiger. See, already you know this about this also.
Yeah. This.
That's a no need of this because we know it.
So Lion Tiger will have the skin color camouflage with the surrounding environments.
Yeah, sir,
completely carnivorous only. So they will feed upon the other animals.
And it has strong sense of smelling to look at their prey.
Lion is called as king of the jungle.
Sir, lion is called, but tiger is not.
Yeah, tiger is different. Lion is the king of the jungle.
Yeah, sir, and also it has strong claws. Strong.
So about these two, we'll discuss in the next class. So just you can go through it once again. It's easy only. Okay. So complete your homework, and I'll inform you about the test details in the group itself. Whether it can be tomorrow evening, okay?
Sir, actually, you told today exam, but you.